You might feel like, where should I start? How do I start? I have nothing more to say, being on YouTube, being on videos, why should I even be on video? But deep down there, you really want to start one, but you have all those questions and you might even feel freaked out because you feel like it's saturated, there's everybody here, nobody, there's no room for you anymore, it's 2020, the crisis out there is not helping. All those stuff just make you be a little bit more freaked out onto the possibility for you to actually start one. Whenever we try something new, it's always scary, right? It's normal, it's new, it's another life, it's another chapter for you. It's all good to ask yourself those questions. But here, this video, I'm gonna talk you through the main questions you should actually ask yourself in order to create a story where you can share it here on YouTube and how make it really much more true to you in order for people to be attracted to you and your channel and even have more subscribers. So let's just talk into it and let's just talk through it. So to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue dans la Annie canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no channel ni yokoso. I hope you're doing fine today. This is another day, another week, and another video of me. And we're gonna have a really nice, juicy video, which is all about sharing your story. You don't know what to say, you don't know where to start, you're freaking out about starting that YouTube channel. We all been through it, even the biggest YouTubers out there, they've been through it, but it was not an overnight success. It was a lot of hard work, it was a lot of challenges, and they will still not here. So if you feel like you're the only one out there, you're not. For those who don't know yet, I'm Lady Tomo. I'm a style coach and I'm dedicated, passionate about helping creative women entrepreneurs turn their gifts into money machines if it's something that you truly want to do. And I use the video for that, all combining you being confident, using your personal style, using it into your own branding and make it really authentic for you. I've been in Cameroon, I've been in Europe before, and now I live in Canada. This is a part of my story. But what made it hard for me was to actually show up on YouTube. Speaking English is not my first language. Speaking French is my first language. So the fear was real. The fear was real to show up on videos and being judged by potential 1,000 people, you know what I mean? And it hasn't changed ever since. I just keep doing. I just keep pushing. I got to be a lot more comfortable. I got to be a lot more confident into what I was sharing to the world because I actually was realizing bit by bit that I didn't have to be perfect. I just had to be me, and it was more than enough for me and for people watching my videos. So if you feel like you are at that place where you don't know what to say and you feel confused about all of that, let me tell you, I'm telling you, you have that unique gift that people just can't wait to see from you. It's bigger than anything. You can have all the strategies out there, all the things out there, all the tools out there, but if you don't believe in you, this is where there's an issue. So here are the questions that are gonna help you create a story so your first video can be all about it. The first question to ask here is, what is your biggest achievement? It could be anything. And don't think about something that is, I would say, big. It's not a competition. Would it be bigger than the other person? You know what I mean? So it's all about being you. It's all about your story again here. So your biggest achievement could be anything simple, anything interesting, because it's important to you. And when you're gonna talk about it, people are gonna feel that energy from you. My biggest achievement was to be able to definitely start that YouTube channel because I was scared just like you 10 years ago. I recently decided to dive deep into YouTube and behind the scene and really get to combine the personal side along with it, but I'm still feeling scared to talk about YouTube hacks or YouTube pro tips because I feel like I'm not enough, and sometimes I have that doubt and I have to coach myself into it and really take it into consideration everything that I've done so far. So even if it's not so big for a lot of people out there, it's still something important for people that are actually gonna watch my channel. So this is where I make it important for me, and this is where you should make your answer important for yourself in order for people to take it and make it important for them. So the second question is, what is the bravest thing you ever done? Again, could be anything. I don't know, traveling, going into a country that you had no idea you could be going, you know what I mean? I've been in Cameroon, I've been in Canada for 14 years now, I've been in Europe before, and it's definitely been something I could take a lot of pride on, because I know how it's hard to leave your family, and that distance is something that people can find challenging. I can definitely tell you that. But it comes to your personality as well, because my own personality, I tend to be good doing that because I still rely on the internet, WhatsApp, Skype, FaceTime, and it wasn't my choice, by the way, it was my parents, so that could be your bravest thing. That question is, how did you come up with the idea of your business? What are the fire? What is that motivation for you? What is your big why? And that is so important, even for you, because it's your fire. It's gonna be the reason for you to wake up every single day. It could be a beautiful story by itself. So when you're gonna talk about it, you're gonna realize that there's much more into starting it than just like for you to just starting it, you know? So simple, I couldn't fit in. I used to live in a society where everything was much more laid back. Not necessarily laid back, no. Let me take it back, not laid back, because chic appearance and dressing up still does matter a lot in Africa. African people, they're not joking with the appearance. You gotta dress up. Kawaii style, which is a cute type of style in Japan, all those little things made me be the person who I am today, where I'm a really, really edgy person, but it's not much more so the appearance of it. Whatever I feel inside, I reflect it through my own personal style. I could dress up a lot, even staying at home, just because I want to feel a certain way. So it's not about impressing other people more than myself. So all of that is a story that you can definitely share with people for where you start when it comes to your own business, your own story, and how it's really tied to your own personal story and how you... What is the most challenging thing that you ever had to do? That's a question you should ask yourself. What is that difficult thing that you thought you were not gonna do and you did it? What is that? Because when you're gonna think about it, you're gonna even see yourself being a lot stronger than you actually think you are. Because usually we live day by day and we don't realize our past and whatever we got to accomplish in our past that made us be so much more powerful today. So it's for you to be grateful for all the challenges you've been through, because they made you be the person you are today. So those challenging things is the thing that you can teach to other people, how to overcome their fears, how to overcome any type of little challenge that you know you've been through and that you know how to overcome, you know? It could be a really great way to start a business if you had no idea where you should start. I've got to learn many languages. I've learned, well, English, because Cameroon is bilingual, so you kind of gotta learn. Cameroon is mostly French. After that, my own special interests were like the Spanish, Japanese, I don't need to say more about it, Japanese, Korean. I was like, I want to learn. So I got myself into learn Japanese by myself when I was a lot younger, like learning the characters, learning the languages. And then when I got to Canada, this is where I definitely got serious into learning the language at university. So that's what I did. That's why I did for many years, for 3 years actually. Got to be at a level where I could actually speak it. And I was so proud of myself. And I would never have thought that I would be even able to do it, to be honest, because it was a wish, it was something that I wanted to do, but it was still something that I wasn't sure that I was able to do. So what fact about you surprises others. I say a beautiful story because when we get to see people, we're assuming a lot of things based on their appearances. And I'm really, really big and really against it because I've suffered myself from looking a certain way. When you get to know somebody, yes, society makes us think about certain people looking a certain way. So if you see somebody that is dressed up in a really type of not necessarily the most cleanest person, you're gonna assume that maybe it's homeless, you know what I mean? If somebody, I don't know, looks a little bit more sketchy in the middle of the night, you're walking the street, being a woman, you're gonna be freaking scared because you're gonna say that guy is dangerous, he might do something. If somebody looks gothic, you're gonna be like, oh my god, it looks so dark, it looks so sad. Maybe it's because he doesn't trust himself, he just wants to hide away from the world. And sometimes it's the case, but sometimes it's not the case, you know? So make it in a way where you ask yourself or you ask people that know you what facts actually are surprising from the beginning when they were getting to know you more. Because I'm telling you, it's always, always interesting to see how people can assume a lot of things based on what they're gonna see from me. That could be something that you can share to your audience when you're building one. When I say that I'm really big into Japanese anime or really big into video games, again, surprises. I remember that time. I went and bought my PS4 a couple of years back, and the guy, he didn't even ask, he assumed that my PS4, the PS4 that I was buying, was for either my boyfriend or my brother. And when I said, I was like, oh, you know, it's for me, it's my Christmas gift, because it was like during Christmas, he was surprised because I look too feminine to like video games. Yeah, I was having so much. I was laughing because I was like, oh wow, okay, it was, well, it's for me. Fancy, and I like feminine, but you know, I can enjoy the video games as well, and I can enjoy as well. The next question is, what experience do you value the most? Being with others, connecting to others, but it has to be something really, really true to you. So what is that experience that you value the most? I like being by myself, I like being at home. I'm not so much bigger into, let's say, connecting most of the time, because for me it could be draining, for me it could be another type of experience where I really, really enjoy it, but at the same time I'm much more shy in a way where I'm more laid back, because I can look fancy, I can look feminine, but in my private life I'm much more so sarcastic, but at the same time I like being by myself. What is important for me is to really get to know people the way they are and really get to that depth core of somebody. What experience do you value the most? Do you like traveling? Do you like drawing? Do you like reading? Do you like talking to people, connect with people? All those things make you being you, you know? Share it with the audience, share it with people, share it more and more. Every time that you talk to somebody, a bit about yourself, and being used to talk about yourself that way, being kind with you, you practice. Because when you're gonna get in front of the camera, you're gonna feel like you have a blank, like your brain is just gonna go blank. So the more you're gonna do it, the more you're gonna take the habit of doing it, the more you're gonna be in front of the camera doing it in the most natural way ever. Other thing inspires you the most? It could be your mom, it could be your dad, it could be your family, it could be an actress, it could be a hero, it could be a Japanese anime too. I'm just saying. Yeah. City Hunter, Nicky Larson in France. I used to be in love with the guy. Oh, he was so cute. That was like my hobby when I was young. Who inspires you the most and why? Michelle Obama is a woman that I admire so much. I did a video about her, especially when it comes to the personal branding. Definitely take a look at it, how she showcases herself to this world, because she's still funny, she's still being really light, and oh, just love her personality and obviously her look as well. I love Lupita Nyong'o. I think she's just amazing. I've always been obsessed over Ayumi Hamasaki, a Japanese singer that made me discover more about Japanese songs, Japanese culture, and then I got to South Korea when I discovered B-Rain, Seven, B, BTS is now the biggest thing ever right now. And back then, there was a lot of DBSQ TV back then. Ask me what others say about you. Are you cray cray? Ow! How to hit myself? Are you straight to the bullet? Are you sarcastic? Are you funny? Are you not funny? Are you being too serious? You know? Are you being too geeky, weird, gutsy, edgy, lunatic, weird, crazy? All those things make you be you, you know? I mean, I'm not sure here. Like, dressed up, laid back, shy, cute, weird. In a good way, in a good way, in a good way. Being a part of being you are just interesting because they're gonna be the things that people are gonna be able to relate the most to. Because what others say about you is usually what your viewers, your subscribers, your own audience, they're gonna say about you. So, is it because you have a high energy? Is it because you listen a lot? Always the one being really, really analytic, practical when it comes to certain situations. Not a person that can recommend you any type of romantic movies. I'm just not into it, sorry, not sorry. If you're looking to have any type of event and organize it, most of the time I would just let my social friend do it for me because they're the best at doing it. So it's not about knowing your weaknesses. Friends. That's it for the questions. I hope you liked it. The last thing I would say is to stop comparing yourself to others. I think when it comes to starting a YouTube channel, we have a lot of questions because we feel like we need to be that person. We need to be that person. I've been talking to much more people lately, and something that just always comes back is I want to be like her. She has a million views. Why can't I be like her? I want to do the same thing. When in reality, not only you compare yourself to somebody who's been in the game for 10 years to start with, and you're just starting out, the second thing is that you can be somebody else because everybody else is taken. So when it comes to you, what is that thing that you can showcase to the world? What is that unique gift that you're gonna bring to the world? Think about it that way. And It's hard because when you get to be on Instagram, for example, all day long scrolling down, you always find yourself comparing yourself to other people out there. You shouldn't do that. So the comparison game is something you should avoid at all costs. Make it intentional when you go on social media to avoid comparing yourself. Make it intentional. If you feel that way, retract. I hope you liked it. It was everything for today. I hope you liked it. I hope you adored it. And of course, I'm gonna see you for my next video. And let me know, give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to this channel. There's gonna be a lot more videos like that. And of course, let me know what was your best takeaway from that. Because, well, you know, it's always helpful to know ourselves a little bit better at that level. Especially if you want to start something new. Like I say all the time, keep smiling because it's free and contagious. Bye.